Hey, Mike with Rogue Pest Control here. And do you think that you have a mouse issue in your house? Well, today's video, I'm gonna go through the top three warning signs you wanna look for to know if you have mice in your house, so stay tuned. Now, typically rodent issues and mice issues tend to happen on a seasonal basis, but they can certainly happen throughout the year. You know, typically it tends to happen more in the winter and fall months, just because as temperatures drop and seasons change, rodents are going to look for a better place to live, a better place to survive, where there's ample food sources, water sources, and shelter as well. So typically that's when you'll find rodent issues and mice issues in your home. But like I said, they can happen throughout the year. So the first issue and warning sign you want to look for mice in your home is mouse droppings around your home. So mice are going to leave a lot of droppings around your home, and they can be in common areas that you'll see all the time, but they can also be hidden as well. So you might look for them underneath appliances, behind appliances. They could be hidden in cabinets and cupboards or areas where they might have access to food sources around your home. But typically these droppings are going to look like tiny grains of rice, and they can range in size from 3/16 of an inch up to 1/4 of an inch. And then they're also going to range in color from black to brown. And depending on how old they are, they might even look gray as well. Now, this could also be confused with rat droppings. And basically though, at the same time, rat droppings are just going to be much bigger. They're going to be a similar shape and same coloration. But like I said, they're going to be bigger than that 1/4 of an inch size if you have rats in your home versus mice. So definitely be on the lookout for these droppings, and they can leave a lot, right? Most mice are going to leave anywhere from 50 to 75 of these around your home every single day. So you're going to start to notice them if you have mice issues in your home. Now, if you do find these, definitely be safe with them. Like, they do carry a lot of bacteria and potential diseases. So make sure you wear gloves and don't sweep them or vacuum them up, because again, that can just spread that bacteria and spread that disease around your house even more than where they actually are. So be sure to be careful when handling these and cleaning these up. But then at the same time, in addition to finding mouse droppings, you can also start to smell mouse urine. It has a very strong, potent smell to it. Unlike the droppings, typically those don't seem to smell at all. So you might not smell those around your house, but you'll certainly see them. But then when it comes to the urine, it has a very strong ammonia smell to it. So you might smell that around your home as well. Now, at the same time, obviously one single mouse doesn't urinate a ton. So if you're smelling this around your home, there's probably a good sign that there are a lot of mice hiding out around your home. Now, the next warning sign that you want to look for mice in your house is basically that there's going to be different gnaw marks or poles or chew marks around your house. So mice typically chew on things like wood, walls, furniture, and sometimes even wires inside of walls around your home. So rodents are pretty skittish, so they tend to hide out in hard to reach places. So mice, you'll often find them in between walls, in attics, basically areas that are closed off from humans or don't get a lot of interaction. You know, sometimes they've even been known to hide in closets and in shoes. So pay attention to that. If you're seeing mice around your home, they could be hiding out in your closets as well. But again, like I said, they like to chew on different things, and this can actually be a part of them building their nests as well. So if you're seeing damage to things like cardboard, clothing, paper products, different things like that, fabrics, sheets around your house, it could be the work of mice in your home as well. So like I said, they're going to be building their nests out of those, hiding those throughout your home. And then like I said though, a dangerous aspect is that when they do happen to chew on wires, that could actually lead to fire issues in your home with frayed wires. So having mice issues in your home is no joke. You definitely want to get rid of those as soon as possible. But again, that's another big warning sign, is that you're going to see gnaw marks, chew marks, like I said, maybe on your furniture, on walls. You're going to find holes in walls leading to hard to reach spaces in your home. So look for that as well. The third warning sign you're going to look for is actually hearing mice before you see them. So you might hear them scampering around your home. You might hear them chewing on things, gnawing on things in the walls and attics, different things like that. Like I said, mice are very skittish, so they tend to come out at night when humans aren't as active. They tend to dart quickly and hide as fast as possible, hiding under appliances, different things like that. So you might hear them, you know, their little pitter-patter feet going around your home, going throughout your walls. You might hear them chewing on different stuff inside the walls, in the attic, far earlier than you might actually see them around your home. So pay attention to that. If you're hearing things moving around in your walls, little things going on, it could be another good warning sign that you have mice and rodents in your home. So, you know, overall, those are the top three things that you want to look for. Again, mouse droppings, chew marks around your home or holes around your home, and actually hearing them running around throughout your home. Now, some different prevention tips you can use is going to be sealing entry points. So sealing those points where mice and rodents can get in. Like I said, this is especially important around the fall and winter months because those are the major times rodents are going to try and get into your home. But then on top of that, you also want to eliminate food sources for these mice and rodents. So proper sanitation, sealing food around your home can help reduce those numbers as well if there are rodents trying to get into your home, and help reduce mice issues in your home as well. Now, on top of that, it's very important, like I said, to get rid of these mice in your home as quickly as possible. One, for that potential fire issue damage that they're doing throughout the walls and wiring in your home. But on top of that, these rodents breed incredibly fast. So they can create massive litters, you know, 6 to 12 at a time. They're going to be breeding every few weeks. So one or two mice can turn into a very large issue very quickly if they're left unchecked. So again, if you're finding mice in your home, you're experiencing some of these warning signs, we really recommend reaching out to a pest control service. Again, mice can be very hard to trap and kill and get rid of on your own. Again, they're skittish. They don't necessarily go to the traps very easily. Different baits you need to use depending on what the mice already like and are looking for. So reaching out to a pest control service can be one of the best ways to get rid of mice very quickly in your home, especially if you're experiencing any of these warning signs as well. So again, hopefully you guys got some benefit and value out of this video. If you did, feel free to comment and share, and be sure to subscribe to our channel to get the latest pest control tips and tricks to keep your home pest free. And then also, if you have mice issues, rodent issues, or anything else pest related, feel free to reach out to us over at rovepestcontrol.com. And then also, as a first-time customer, you can get a $50 discount by heading to rovepestcontrol.com/50off. So as a first-time customer, take advantage of that great discount at rovepestcontrol.com/50off. But once again, thanks for tuning in. We'll talk to you more soon.